Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you are well. Welcome to the video series Destroyed Civilizations. In today's episode, we will explore the lost city of art, a city mentioned in the Holy Quran, and a city that has come to light in recent scientific discoveries. The city of Ad also referred to the Lost Arabian City, or the Atlantis of the Sands, was once a flourishing civilization of its time, an epicenter of agriculture and commerce. Historic reports position the city of Ad in the Al-Ahqaf region, today known as the Southern Arabian Peninsula between Yemen and Oman. Amidst a harsh desert environment, the city of Ad was described as a city blessed with gardens and springs, cattle and vegetation, agricultural wonders with towering columns, and a people of great wealth. Descriptions of the city of Ad appear in historical documents and cultural oral tales from the desert-dwelling Bedouins of Arabia. Amongst the three books of scriptures, the Bible, the Torah, and the Holy Quran, there is no mention of the city of Ad in the Bible and Torah. The Quran refers to the people of the city of Ad as a nation that had built a significant civilization, with particular reference to their agriculture accomplishments, a city of huge pillars that was groundbreaking for its time. In the Quran, "Did you not see how your Lord dealt with the people of Ad of the city of Iram, with lofty pillars, the like of which were not produced in all the land?" In reference to the flourishing gardens and springs in the city of Ad, the Quran mentions, "In the Quran, now fear Allah and obey me. Fear Him who has bestowed on you freely all that you know. Freely has He bestowed on you cattle and sons, and gardens and springs. Truly I fear for you the penalty of a great day." Now, as for tribe of Ad on earth, they walked arrogantly against all right, saying, "Who could have power greater than we?" Were they then not aware that Allah, who created them, had power greater than them? And they went on with rejection of our revelation. And as for Ad, they were destroyed by a screaming, violent wind. Which Allah imposed upon them for 7 nights and 8 days in succession. So you would see the people therein fallen as if they were hollow trunks of palm trees. Then do you see of them any remains? At the time of revelation of the Quran, over 1400 years ago, there was no sign of the city of Ad. Inviting question by some that this city and its people were a legendary tale. However, recent scientific discoveries are supported by Quranic evidence. It was the English researcher, namely Bertam Thomas, who authored the book Arabia Felix in year 1932. Bertam Thomas traveled extensively to the Southern Arabian Peninsula between Yemen and Oman. From his travels, he met local Bedouins who, like their ancestors, shared the stories of the city known as Ubar. And like many before them, the Bedouins showed Bertam the well-worn tracks leading to the ancient city. Bertam would not live to see the fruition of his exploration and died before the completion of his research. His work inspired famous documentary filmmaker, author and lecturer of archaeology Nicholas Clapp, who found the legendary city mentioned in the Quran. Nicholas Clapp conducted extensive research on ancient manuscripts and found hand-drawn maps as early as in the year 200 by Greek geographer Ptolemy, which unveiled the location of the old city. He used the data from his research and from the works of Bertam Thomas, supported by the oral narratives of Bedouins, to pinpoint the city's location. But to prove his discovery, he needed strong scientific evidence, to which he approached NASA for satellite imagery. Armed with satellite images from NASA, old maps and data acquired from ancient scriptures, Nicholas located the lost city of Arabia. With little time to waste, excavations began, and remains of the old city were found and brought to the surface for the first time in thousands of years. the Lost City was dubbed Uber, the Atlantis of Sands. But the question remains, what proved this discovery to be the city of the people of Ad as mentioned in the Quran? From the very beginning of the study and site excavation, it was understood that this ruined city belonged to the civilization of the people of Ad. Researchers discovered Iram's pillars, which were specifically mentioned in the Quran in the form of towers in the land of the people of Ad. Dr. Juri Zarins, a member of the research team leading the excavation, said that since the towers were alleged to be the distinctive feature of Uber, and since Iram was mentioned as having towers of pillars, this then was the strongest proof so far that the site they had unearthed was Iram, the city of Ad as described in the Quran. In the Quran, "Do you not see what your Lord did with Ad, Iram of the columns, whose like was not created in any land?" So how was the city of Ad destroyed? What led to their demise and why? But before we do, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, click the subscribe button now and be sure to click the notification bell to be the first to watch the latest uploaded videos from Sense Islam. In the Quran, Ad are said to have burst through a furious wind. In the verses of the Quran, it is mentioned that this furious wind lasted for 7 nights and 8 days and totally destroyed Ad. The Ad too rejected, "Then how terrible was my penalty and my warning, for we sent against them a furious wind on a day of violent disaster, plucking out men as if they were roots of palm trees torn up from the ground. And the Ad, they were destroyed by a furious wind, exceedingly violent. He made it rage against them 7 nights and 8 days in succession, so that they could see the whole people lying prostrate in its path, as they had been roots of hollow palm trees tumbled down." Though warned previously through messenger Prophet Hud alayhi salam, the people of Ad paid no attention and belligerently refuted the message. At the time of their destruction, they were in such a state of delusion that they could not comprehend or fathom what was happening when they saw the destruction unfold before them. To the very end, they remained steadfast in their denial. Then, when they saw the penalty in the shape of a cloud traversing the sky, coming to meet their valleys, they said, "This cloud will give us rain. No, it is the calamity you were asking to be hastened, a wind wherein is a grievous penalty." The people of Ad saw the cloud that would bring them to their demise, but could not fathom it was a punishment that they long taunted messengers before. "If your Lord is true, then bring the punishment." As arrogance is blind, the people of Ad thought the dark cloud was a blessing of rain. This is an interesting observation of the nature of the calamity, because a cyclone proceeding along whipping up the desert sand also seems like a rain cloud from a distance. It is possible that the people of Ad were deceived by this appearance and did not notice the calamity. The most important evidence showing that the city of Ad was buried by a sandstorm is the use of the word Ahqaf in the Quran to signify the location of Ad. The description used in Surah Al-Ahqaf is as follows. In the Quran, mention Hud, one of Ad's own brethren. Behold, he warned his people about the winding sand tracts. But there have been warners before him and after him. Worship none other than Allah. Truly, I fear for you the penalty of a mighty day. Ahqaf means sand dunes in Arabic, and it is the plural form of the word Hikf, which means a sand dune, a testament of the sand dunes in and around the civilization of Ad, and the most logical ground possible for the fact that they were buried by a sandstorm. According to one interpretation, Ahqaf lost its meaning of sand hills and became the name of the region in South Yemen where Ad lived. This does not change the fact that the root of this word is sand dunes, but just shows that this word has since become peculiar to this area because of the abundant sand dunes in the region. In comparison to their grandeur, status and history, the destruction that befell Ad would have annihilated the population in a very short time. A civilization that thrived by cultivating fertile lands with elaborate irrigation channels, making the city of Ad an epicenter of trade and agricultural significance for its time. Yet, the entire population with the city of all its wealth were covered in sand and buried alive. And in an act of poetic justice, just like the people whom covered the truth, they too were covered by the blowing winds of desert sands, long forgotten, unseen and unnoticed for thousands of years, until now. It can be said that historical and archaeological finds indicate that the long-lost civilization of Ad and the city of Iram were destroyed as described in the Quran. Thousands of years later, the remains of the people of Ad have been recovered from the sands. Countless historic lessons have been given to those who believe. And to those who do not believe, we reflect upon those buried in the sands and take heed as the Quran states. Ad went astray of the right path because of their arrogance and said, "Who is superior to us in strength?" In the rest of the verse, it is said, "What, did they not see that Allah, who created them, was superior to them in strength?" The moral to the story is all prosperity and gratitude is from and belongs to Allah, and that one's prosperity is attained through his worship and monotheism. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and please share our videos with your loved ones. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.